Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to do this ball of water effect in HitFilm Express. So we're going to be using the free version of HitFilm Express. This is version 12.3, and you can download this for free at fxhome.com. And I will leave a link in the description below. This has been done by the folks over at ProductionCrate. I will leave a link to ProductionCrate as well. But they did it in After Effects, and then it was sort of bantered around in the HitFilm forums on a discussion thread. So I will leave a link to that discussion thread in the description below. But I played around with it, and after following the ProductionCrate tutorial as well as some tips and advice from the folks on the forums, I came up with this as my best effort for the ball or sphere of water effect. I'm going to start by creating a new composite shot, and it's just going to be the background. And I'm going to bring in this random stock footage of a brick wall, and I'm just going to transform fit to frame on that. You can just do that by right-clicking. Then I'll go ahead and create a second composite shot, and I'm going to call this the final. And just for purposes of this particular tutorial, I'm going to only make it 10 seconds long, and I'm going to just drag in the background footage so that way I have something I can place the ball or sphere of water in front of, okay? I'm going to start by adding a new plane layer. It can be black, that is fine. Clicking OK, it's covering the entire screen, but I will start by adding the sphere effect. And that effect is, by default, 200 pixels. You can make it whatever you want. I'm going to make it 300 pixels just so that it's a little bit bigger. The second effect I'm going to add will be the fractal noise effect. And I will drop that onto the plane underneath. If I open that up, I'm going to only make a couple of changes. One is I'm going to change it to a fluid fractal noise, because obviously since it's a ball of water, it will look better if it's a fluid. Although, to be honest, I played around using the cloud effect, and it works pretty well as well. The other thing I'm going to do is open up the transform property, and under position, I'm going to keyframe that position to move on its x-axis. So I'm going to set a keyframe at the first frame zero, and then 10 seconds in, I'm going to just move this 1,000 pixels to the right. So now you can see that it is just sort of, you know, sliding along on the horizontal axis, like if it was going to be spinning. To make it look more round, the third effect I will be adding is the bulge effect, and I'm going to drop that on underneath the fractal noise. Now, if you notice, the bulge effect is actually automatically set to be 300 pixels in radius, but you would want to make that whatever the radius of the sphere is. And also, you can see the outline of the bulge is bulging out, and so that's what I'm looking for. But in a minute, when I create the other side of the translucent sphere, I will change that. So there is, now we're getting this sort of roundish look on this. The next thing I'm going to add is the heat distortion effect. Now, I could add the fluid distortion effect, but it does not come in the free version of HitFilm, so I'm not going to add that. But if you have Pro, you're certainly welcome to add that. What I have noticed is it increases the render time considerably, like 5 times as long. So something that might take only 10 minutes to render all of a sudden takes 50 or 60 minutes to render on my computer. And so the fluid distortion doesn't seem to do much different than the heat distortion. So I'm sticking with the heat distortion. And everything that I am putting in here, the fractal noise, the sphere, the bulge, and the heat distortion, all of these numbers can be changed and played with. So I'm just giving you a basic setup that you would then tweak and work into your scene, okay? And the final effect that I'm going to add is the chrominator effect, and I'm going to drop this on. This is just going to make it look more watery, and it's actually a very neat little nifty effect that I rarely have used, but again, you can adjust the different numbers that are in here to suit your style. Now from here, I want to create the back side of this. So I'm going to right click on that plane and just duplicate it, opening that up. Under the effects, I'm going to make a couple of changes. One is under the fractal noise, transform position properties, which has already been keyframed to go from 0 to 1,000. I'm just going to change that 1,000 to negative 1,000. And so it's going the other direction. And then secondary to that, under the bulge effect, instead of it bulging outward, I want it to bulge inward. So I'm just going to move the circle so that it bulges inward this way. Okay. Now that I've done that, I will grab both of those planes and I will right click on them and change their blend mode to overlay so that they sort of integrate within the background itself. Okay. Then I will want to create a sort of distortion effect looking through this ball of water behind there to the brick wall or whatever my background plane is. So I'm going to right click on both of these and duplicate them. And then I'm going to drag those underneath the background composite shot and add a new grade layer, which I will place above those in my composite timeline. This will bake in those two if I source the grade layer itself. I'm going to search now for another heat distortion effect, which I'm going to directly apply to the background composite shot. This will make the entire shot heat distorted, but if I open up the properties of it and I source the mask to that grade layer, then it will restrict it to only where the ball of water is. Okay, and when I'm done, I have something that looks like this. Now, it's important that you understand that you can actually change the color of this. Right now, it's sort of black and white. And if I just do a search in the search bar for the different colors, you can see that color one is black and color two is white. So you might take color one, for instance, and, you know, just back it down slightly, maybe say to 50. Okay. And then if I were to do that with color two, and I'm just going to do that by using the eyedropper, then you would get something that looks like this. So it just sort of depends. You can actually tint it different colors like blue, for example. If you are looking to do some sort of a magic orb, you might change it to red or yellow or green or some other color. And other than that, though, that's pretty much the effect that we're looking for. Notice that this effect really works against a number of different backgrounds. Doesn't matter whether it's a dark colored background or maybe a light colored background. Either way, doesn't really matter. Once you've set up the general effect, then you can essentially place it in any background that you want. If you attach that to a point and you move the point around, then you could get some pretty neat little water bending effects. So if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.